Hello children,
hope you all are good and safe. Today we are going to start a new chapter, chapter 5, birds, their feathers and beaks. But before that we will solve exercise questions of chapter 2, which was your last home assignment, that is 5th home assignment. Okay, now you all know what you have to do. You have to match your answers with my answers, and if any correction is needed, you have to do that in your science book.
So children, here is the exercise questions, page number 25, question number A. Tick the right options. First one, building blocks of our body are cells. Okay, you will tick it out. Okay, now question number 2, kidney is an example of, you all know, organ. Kidney is an organ. You will take it out. Now question number 3, bones join together to form a framework called skeleton. You will take it out. Okay, now fourth one is, eyes are the organs of sight. Option A is the correct answer. Now fifth one is, brain, spinal cord and nerves, what they form? Nervous system. So option B is the correct answer. Now question B is, fill in the blanks with given options. Here some options are given. So first one, excretory system helps to remove the waste and toxic materials from the body. In second one, you will write, breaking down of complex food into simple food is known as digestion. Now third one, the circulatory system is composed of heart, blood and blood vessels. Fourth one is, there are 206 bones in our body. Okay, you can see spellings from given options. Now question C is, give one word for the following. First one is, number of cells joined together to form, you all know, tissue. T-I-S-S-U-E, tissue. Now second one, number of bones in our body, you all know, 206. Now third one is, it carries oxygen and digested food to all parts of body. Yes, that is blood. B-L-O-O-D, blood. Now fourth one is, the process which release energy in our body. That is respiration. R-E-S-P-I-R-A-T-I-O-N, respiration. Now fifth one is, the system that helps to produce babies. Reproduction. R-E-P-R-O-D-U-C-T-I-O-N, reproduction. Now question D is, label the following diagram. You all know this is of excretory system. Here these are kidneys. You will write K-I-D-N-E-Y, kidney. Now this one, these two tubes are ureter, U-R-E-T-E-R, ureter. Now this one is bladder, B-L-A-D-D-E-R, bladder. Okay, or you can write urinary bladder. Now last one is urethra, U-R-E-T-H-R-A, urethra. Okay, like this you will label it. Now next one is, match the following terms. System which release energy, that is respiration. So you will match it with fourth picture. Here this is respiratory system. Now second one is, system which circulates materials. So you will match it with the first picture, that is circulatory system. Now third one is, system which helps to remove waste. Yes, this is excretory system. You will match it with the third picture. Now fourth one is, bony frame of our body, that is skeleton. So you will match it with skeleton system. Now fifth one, building blocks of organism, that are cells. So you will match it with cells. Okay, now next question. Write true or false. First one, undigested food pass out through anus. Yes, this is true. Now second one, lung is the main pumping organ. No, this is false, because heart is the main pumping organ. Now third one, skeleton gives shape and support to our body. Yes, this is true. Now fourth one, kidneys are the part of nervous system. This is false.
So now children, let's start a new chapter. Okay. Now children, birds are very beautiful creature in this world. They are different from plants and animals. And there are more than 8600 species of birds. Now you all have seen birds. How they are? They are the animals with feathers. And they have a light-weighted body. That's why they fly so high. Okay. And what they have? They have wings attached to their body. How they are attached? With the help of muscles. So they have wings attached to their body with the help of muscles. And how they fly? Like this. Okay. So they can flap their wings in both direction, upward and downward. Okay. So upward direction, the movement of upward direction of flap is known as upstroke. And movement of downward direction is known as downstroke. Okay, so they can flap their wings in both the directions. Now children, what I have said, that birds are the animals with feathers and they have wings. Now don't get confused between feathers and wings. Feathers are different and wings are different. Okay. Feathers are hair-like structures and they keep the bird's body warm. Okay, they are large in numbers and they are of different colors. Feathers, okay. But wings are the large structure attached to the body of the birds with the help of strong muscles. And they help the bird to fly. Okay, wings help the bird to fly. So children, what we have learned? Birds are the animals with feathers. Feathers are small hair-like structures. They keep the body warm. Birds have wings attached to their body with the help of strong muscles. Wings help the bird to fly. Birds can flap their wings in both the directions, upward and downward. The upward movement of wings is known as upstroke. The downward movement of wings is known as downstroke. Now children, there are mainly three types of feathers: body feathers, down feathers and flight feathers. Now body feathers cover the body of the bird. And they are different in colors and they are large in numbers. They give a shape to the body of the bird. This is the function of body feathers. Okay, you have seen peacock feathers, hen's feather. They are of different colors. They have many colors. So these are called body feathers, which cover the bodies and give the shape to the body and of different colors. Now second one is down feathers. Down feathers are very soft and fluffy. Have you seen that newborn bird? It has small hair like structures. They are known as down feathers. They keep the body of the bird very warm. Okay, so soft and fluffy feathers are known as down feathers. They keep the body of the bird warm. Now third one is flight feathers. As the name sounds, flight feathers. So these feathers are long in size and they are mainly found on the wings and on the tails, and they help the birds to fly. This is the function of flight feathers. Okay, so these are the three types of feathers. And children, some birds are there which cannot fly. For example, penguin and ostrich, because they are too heavy to fly. One more thing to be remembered is birds have light-weighted body as well as they have streamlined body. Streamlined body means the shape of their body is like that they can easily fly, or they can easily move through the air. So children, let's revise what we have learned. Feathers, there are three type of feathers: body feathers, down feathers and flight feathers. So first one is body feathers. They are small and of different colors. They cover the body of the bird and they give shape to the body of the bird. Now down feathers, they are fluffy and soft, small hair-like structures, and they keep the body warm. Now third one is flight feathers. They are long in size and they are found mainly on the wings and tail. They help the bird to fly. Some birds like ostrich and penguin cannot fly because they are too heavy to fly. Most birds have streamlined body which help them to move easily through the air. Now children, do you know there are some aquatic birds too? Aquatic, aqua means water. Whenever we say aquatic animals, it means we are talking about the water animals. Clear? So there are some aquatic birds. Aquatic birds, those birds which can swim in water. So those birds are called aquatic birds. Now how can they swim in water while others cannot? Because aquatic animals have oil glands on their feathers and they have webbed feet. Now what oil glands does? Children, if we try to mix some water droplets in oil, does it get mixed easily? No. Oil do not absorb water easily. So the oil glands on feathers make the feathers waterproof. Clear? And second thing is webbed feet. They help them to swim easily. So these are the features of aquatic birds. Now children, do you know birds are very helpful to us? They are also very useful to us to maintain our ecosystem and to function our ecosystem smoothly. They also help to scatter the seeds so that trees can grow everywhere. Okay, how it is possible? Actually, whenever birds eat fruits and this type of things which are having seeds in them, after that they fly here and there, and whenever they remove the wastes from their body, the seeds scatter everywhere. Wherever they fly, they go. Then these seeds grow into a new plant. So birds are also very helpful to us. So children, what we have learned? Some birds which can swim in water are known as aquatic birds. Now what are the features of aquatic birds? They have oil glands which keep their feathers waterproof. Second thing is they have webbed feet which help them to swim in water. Birds help in dispersal of seeds. In this way, they support our ecosystem and help it to function smoothly. So children, this much for today, and we will continue our chapter in our next video. But before that, I would request you all, whenever you send your assignments, before sending them, just check them, they are readable or not. Because some of you are sending the assignments, but they are not readable. You are just taking the pictures and sending without checking them. Okay. Also send the worksheet work, whatever you have done, because some of you are not sending the worksheet work. Clear? So this much, and till our next video, be safe, stay at home and take care.